look at my job really as just being who I am. So I just kind of concentrate on, you know, every time I sing a song or perform, that it really is me, and that I'm not thinking about anything else, just thinking about the song.
With a captivating vocal presence of extraordinary range and a heartfelt, soulful sound, Lisa Keith makes her solo recording debut with her new album, Walkin' in the Sun. While Lisa's solo career is new, this gifted artist is actually a seasoned pro. She already has an impressive track record as a singer, songwriter, and musician. Lisa co-wrote songs like Why Should I Cry for Nona Hendrix and Crucial for New Edition, as well as singing with artists like Janet Jackson, Herb Alpert, Karen White, Human League, Johnny Gill, and Mint Condition.
I feel really lucky to have worked with so many artists and to learn from them. I've always enjoyed singing back up for other people, but you know, I always knew I wanted to get out front, so it really feels good, it feels natural.
Hey baby, it's you I truly adore.
For years, Lisa honed her craft with two of the record industry's top producers, Minnesota-based Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis, performing on virtually all of their hits. Now, they're co-producing Lisa's album.
Terry one day came to me and said, I want you to write songs. And I thought, I don't. And, you know, and he said, sure you do. If you talk, you can write lyrics. If you sing, you can write melodies. So I thought I better try. And I gave it a try, and I found out I really, really liked it.
Two arms that can hold me tight. A tender loving kiss that can make it right.
Besides just being the nicest person with no ego, she has a rare combination, I think, of gifts. And she realizes that you have to be more than just a singer. So now she's a singer, writer, co-producer, performer, pianist, whatever. I mean, she really has the whole nine yards. There's an honesty in the way she sings that whenever we hear her sing, we get chills.
Lisa's a great vocalist, artist, period. And to know her as the lover, and then you understand her music even more. We're just trying to have great songs. Not letting the production kind of overburden her, but letting her shine through, I think, was the principal idea in the whole package.
Lisa grew up as part of a large family in suburban Minnesota, where her earliest memories involved expressing herself with her remarkable 3.5-octave range voice.
When I was real little, like maybe 5, I used to sing around the house, and my parents always encouraged me. My dad would always say, wow, you can really sing. And we'd have a blast, my older sister and I singing while we did the dishes. She'd always teach me songs and harmonies, and back then it was just a lot of fun. You know, I've always had the confidence, I've been really blessed that I really felt I can do it. You know, I've never doubted. I thought I can always do it. I've always felt really great about singing.
And even a blind man can tell that he's walking in the sun.
Growing up, Lisa was heavily influenced by the greats of rhythm and blues. Walkin' in the Sun, the album's title track, is a cover of one of her favorite songs, sung by Rufus featuring Chaka Khan.
My biggest influence has got to be Chaka Khan. When I was a teen, I heard her on American Bandstand doing Tell Me Something Good. And I just thought she was the greatest singer I'd ever heard. I went right out and bought the 45, learned it, and still today I think she's probably one of the best singers I know.
Love is a lie, and a world.
The exploration of love and hope is a theme that's close to Lisa's heart, and she expresses it beautifully in her song, Love is Alive and Well, which she co-wrote with another of the album's co-producers, Spencer Bernard.
That's a great song about, you know, people that are looking for that right someone. I mean, it's hard. I know I've got plenty of single friends that are really looking for that right person. It's hard, and they sometimes lose hope, and that song's about, you know, telling them just hold on, because love's out there. It's alive and well.
You're what I need, I believe, baby, you're what I'm waiting for.
A more quiet and contemplative side of Lisa is on display in the delicate World of Joy.
I think, if I had to say, I think it's my favorite song on the album. And I think it makes a great wedding song. I didn't mean it to be that way, but when it got finished, I thought, wow, this would be great at someone's wedding. So I really, really like it.
The album's first single was written by Lisa along with Keith Thomas, who also wrote and produced for Amy Grant and Vanessa Williams. The song is a joyful mix of pop and rhythm and blues, brought to life by Lisa's shining voice, Better Than You.
I guess I just thought of it as a really positive, upbeat song, and with different, you know, different mixes. It could be a dance song, could be just a great listening song. It seems like a great summer song too, in your convertible driving down the street. My first video, and I think it turned out really good. I guess it really was easier than I thought it would be, because it really was. We just kept, you know, performing the song, and they would catch it from different angles, and it was really fun.
Most of all, with the album Walkin' in the Sun, Lisa Keith hopes she not only leaves her audiences entertained, but also inspired by the feelings and emotions that make up her music.
I really hope that it comes across that I care about people. I hope what they know about me is that I'm a very happy person, positive. I feel like if someone listened to my whole album from the beginning to the end, they would definitely know me. I wrote most of the lyrics, and it's really me. It's real. Baby, there's none better.